Florida also reported more than 4,000 new cases today. That's more than yesterday, but still much lower than what we were seeing at the beginning of this month in late July. Now, you might have heard that our state's recent decline in cases is due to a decline in testing, so we looked into that. This chart shows the number of people tested every day in Florida. You can see the testing numbers have definitely gone down since July. Two things I want you to notice here. This bar is obviously higher than the rest. That's the most tests our state recorded in a single day, over 98,000 of them. On the same day, our state recorded over 15,000 COVID-19 positive cases. That's the single day record for the entire country. Now, look at the bar on the far side of this graph, this little orange bar. That was just this Monday, about 20,000 cases reported, fairly low compared to the rest. On the same day, our state recorded the lowest number of COVID-19 cases in almost 2 months, just about 2,600. So why are we seeing this drop in testing, and how does it affect the number of cases reported per day? Well, NBC2's Claire Lavazorio is live outside CenturyLink testing site, getting us those answers tonight.
The Florida Department of Health says there could be many reasons why fewer Floridians are getting tested for COVID-19. They could have already gotten tested earlier this summer, or they may have already had COVID-19. But experts warn this is not the time to slow down.
I wasn't feeling well. Let's get tested. Why not? If it's available.
For some, their symptoms bring them here.
I got a headache and I got a sore throat and I started coughing this morning.
Others are taking a precautionary approach.
A lot of people are taking a lot of things for granted and they just aren't taking it serious.
While not everyone is getting tested for COVID-19 for the same reason, data shows fewer Floridians are.
We don't really know why people aren't coming to get tested, but we encourage people to get tested.
This map from Johns Hopkins shows Florida's testing decline. In mid-July, we recorded a day with nearly 100,000 tests, far exceeding today's numbers. The Department of Health says it's impossible to pinpoint what's behind this testing decline.
It is summertime. I mean, there's a slew of reasons why people may not be getting tested. Kids are getting ready to go back to school. There's different priorities right now.
Although this week's state data may provide a glimmer of hope that testing isn't dead. Latest stats show more than 59,000 tests in a single day this week and a 10,000 test increase from the day before. Experts putting out the reminder that testing is a big part of slowing the spread of COVID-19. Many in line today taking that message to heart.
The sites are available, and if you have any question whatsoever, you should get tested.
CenturyLink saw its peak in number of tests on July 7th, where there were more than 1,200 tests in just one day. We've reached out to the state for updated numbers for testing here at this site for this week, but have yet to hear back. I'm live in Lee County, Claire Lavazorio, NBC2.